Hi friends, how are you? Fine. Good. So, we continue with prepositions and their occurrence. We have seen so far prepositional phrase, for example, under the table. Preposition, noun phrase. Prepositional verb, hang on. Don't hang on here. Then, three, adjective plus preposition, angry at, angry about, angry with someone. For idiomatic, use of two prepositions, with regard to two prepositions. Then fifth one is followed by that clause. He speaks to the effect that all of you are idiots. Example. So today we will see three more and that will be the end of this area. Okay. In order plus infinitive complements. For example, we have I get up early in order to go for a walk. That is infinity complement. He went to the market to buy fish. In order to buy fish. So by the way, I said that in order can be deleted. So that's your automatic reason. He went to buy that is. But he has said they went to the theater. In order to buy tickets or to buy tickets. In order to can be deleted. That's the thing. Or you can say, he came here in order to speak to me. Okay? She danced in order to improve her health. Dancing is good. He danced in order to improve his health. Health. I got up early in the morning in order to go for a walk, morning walk. See, I went late in the afternoon in order to play shuttle. Because early part, you know, that is from 4 to 8, there are too many teams. From 8 onwards, very few people. Only very few people. So late I went, in order to. But then in order to can be left out or deleted, so to say. And then second, seventh is preposition with preposition. For example, here, he came from inside the room. See, preposition, here it is in order, then you have got from inside, two prepositions. Prepositions with preposition. He came from inside, yes. Then, fill the glass in full, you can say. From behind. From inside. He came out from inside. Brutus stabbed Caesar from behind. Understand? From behind. The boys ran out from beside the wall. From beside the wall. Because they were hiding. Alright. Then you can say, they went down around the valley. They went down around. Two preposition. Or you can say, they went down by a cart. They went down by. So you have got from behind, from inside, from beside, down around, down by, and all. So two prepositions. And now, next one what we see is preposition with adjective, plus adjective. Here you have got adjective plus preposition. What is here? Preposition and adjective. You see, she talked to her son in private. In this preposition and the private is adjective. So in private. Preposition with adjective. Preposition plus adjective. Isn't it? And then he said, come and talk to me in private. Fill the glass in full, you can say. In full. Or he can say, he won't come for certain. he won't come for certain. For certain. Of late, people are very happy. Of late, people are very happy. I scolded him, but he gave me flowers in return. In return. So you have got a adjectives. This one is very easy. This is easy. In order to. Preposition, as I told you, you have got a preposition with proposition. From behind, from inside. See examples for this. From behind. From behind. From inside. Down around. Down by. From beside. These are preposition, preposition. And then preposition adjective we have got. In private. In private. In full. See, in private, in full, then you have got a for certain, of late, for certain, of late. So these are preposition with the adjectives, in return. In return. So these are the eight possible places where prepositions can occur. Now what we are going to see is that where we use them. This is possible places we have seen. Eight. First we have seen prepositional phrase. That means there is a preposition as the head word. It will be followed by an NB. NB means a noun phrase. Under the table, on the branch, in the bottle, into the room, like that. Prepositional verb, hang on, depend on, isn't it? Then you have got a stand for means to support, stand for. And then you have got hang on means just wait. Without much reasonable reason. Hang on. Don't hang on the campus after the school hours. Don't hang on. Not that you don't hang, not that. Then adjective preposition, angry at. See? Adjective preposition, angry at, afraid of. Then you have got idiomatic use, like with regard to, in view of, in case of, followed by that clause, you are admitted on condition that you will produce your own results. You are admitted on condition, on the grounds that you misbehave, you are dismissed. Don't do it. Followed by that clause, we have seen that. And now we saw, In order can be omitted. He came in order to kiss me. He came in order to kiss me or talk to me. Yes. Then he came from inside. It is two prepositions. Preposition plus preposition. You have got other examples I told you. From behind and so on. And then last one is preposition with adjective. In private, in full, for certain, of late and so on. I think now it is very clear to you. You have no problem. So we will continue with this. So I told you yesterday, an adventure is an inconvenience wrongly considered. So if you think that learning acquiring a mastery of English prepositions is an inconvenience, then that is an adventure wrongly considered. It's an adventure. It's an intellectual adventure to become the master of or to acquire a mastery of the use of English prepositions. And prepositions are very, very important. They are closed set. That means you have got a fixed number, no addition to that. But noun, adjective, and so on, you can have any number of additions. but propositions are a closed set. Like definite articles, articles closed set. We have only three articles. One is the definite and a and an. We don't have a fourth article. Do we have? And this I don't. Okay, see you. We'll continue this with all our enthusiasm, interest. Considering this as an adventure rather than an inconvenience. Bye. Have a nice time. Enjoy it.